today we're gonna find out which single handle gimbal is the king of stability, but this time we're gonna test it over some uneven terrain. Hey, how's it going, guys? Hope you guys doing well. So with great discovery comes great responsibility. So when DJI released their RS2, I knew I had to do this test since according to my mathematical gimbal stability test, Crane 2S was the standing king of the stability. So here's the order of this video. First, I'm gonna briefly go over the premises of this test. And second, I'm gonna present the result to you right away. And third, I'm gonna address some of the skepticism that you guys might have and or go over some of the requirements I have for this test. And fourth is a bonus test. I call it a bonus test because it's kind of a ridiculous test. And finally, at the end, I'm gonna show you a side-by-side comparison footage so you guys can actually see the result. I didn't want to play that in the middle of the video because I don't want you guys to stare at, you know, orange X move across the screen for like minutes at a time. Now, this is the third time I'm doing this mathematical gimbal stability comparison test. So if you guys want to know more about the origin of how I built that rig and why I did this test, check out the video right here. But the test concept is pretty simple. All I'm really doing is getting a footage of this bright orange X from both gimbals in the same rig, so the motions are the same. And I bring that footage into a post and I track that X on the X-axis and Y-axis to see how many pixels is shifted per frame. And I record all that on the spreadsheet and average it at the end, give it a score. Now the perfect gimbal would score a 0 because it wouldn't move, right? So the higher the number, more unstable the gimbal is. But for this video, I'm gonna give you the percentage of the difference between the two gimbals rather than the actual score point because I think it will make more sense for you guys. Let me show you the camera configuration before I share the result with you guys. So this is the camera I use. This is Sony a7 III with the Sigma 24-70 DG DN. It's a pretty heavy lens for a mirrorless setup. This is a good setup because it's not so light to a point where, you know, you can't really tell the comparison, but it's not so heavy to a point where I can't have this as a control for all gimbal tests. And for the first test, as I would do in real life, I would balance the gimbal at 42 mm. This is smack down in the middle of the lens, and I would actually auto calibrate both gimbals at this focal length, and I made sure that both gimbals were in lock mode. RS2 actually doesn't have what's called lock mode, so I made sure that I went to all the axes, turned out all the axes follow, so it's same as the Crane 2S's lock mode. And what that does is no matter where I point the rig, the camera will stay still and point at the orange X and will not move. So without further ado, this is the test result. Crane 2S versus RS2. And the result is Crane 2S got the score of 0.65 and RS2 got 0.88. So the difference in smoothness is 26%, guys. So I was pretty shocked when I saw that result because on site it's kind of hard to tell on this tiny little screen. In fact, at 42 mm, I knew I had to do this test more than once to make sure it's a precise calculation. So I did this 4 times, guys. So I did some actually walking, and I also did some standing still and shaking the gimbal in place just in case I was off center a little bit. So if I average all 4 tests, Crane 2S is 21% smoother than the RS2. All right, it gets really interesting from here because for the next test, I hyperextend that lens to 70 mm because that's what you would do in real life, right? You see something, you really don't have time to like auto calibrate and rebalance the whole entire gimbal. So at that point, the motor is being stressed and the test result is Crane 2S is the winner, but this time it was 35% more smoother than the RS2. Now there is a mode called super smooth mode on the RS2, so I had to do that test. So from there, I went ahead and actually put the RS2 on super smooth mode, and for this test the result is Crane 2S is still 31% smoother than the RS2. So RS2 gained about 4% smoothness there on the super smooth mode, but not enough to catch up to Crane 2S. And at this point, I can easily say that Crane 2S is much smoother than the RS2. And I can say that easily because I did test 9 times total, guys. So out of 9 times, not even one time the RS2 even catch up to Crane 2S. So it's a very easy test for me to actually tell you guys. All right, so let me address some of the questions and comments you guys had in the past. So one of the questions was, why am I not doing the ninja walk when I do this test? Because aren't you supposed to do the ninja walk when you use a gimbal? So yes, you would not actually use the gimbal like this in real life, right? In a giant rig and walking in sand. But however, for the purpose of this test, if I did a perfect ninja walk and I can make any wobbliest gimbal footage look smooth if I did the ninja walk, and it wouldn't be a good control for a test. So the point of the test is to see which gimbal is really stronger and more responsive and smarter in algorithm, like no matter what kind of environment you throw at it. And if you shot for a long time and you know that you don't always have control over what kind of surface is underneath your feet, like, I mean, I know wedding videographers, you understand, like sometimes it's like patchy grass, sometimes it's nicely waxed floor, sometimes it's like, you know, sand in a beach. But having said that, I did have to put a bunch of controls on this test to make sure that test is accurate as possible. For example, I had to make sure both gimbals are perfectly balanced. I spent like 15 minutes each on balancing the gimbal. And there are many other things I had to consider. In fact, I spent most of the time making sure these things were in place rather than the actual test. The test was just like a small part of it. That's why it got so dark at the end, because I ran out of sunlight. And yes, guys, I am perfectly aware that gimbal smoothness is not just about going in a straight line, but until you have to actually quantify it. So the smoothness I'm gonna define for this test is the ability to absorb any kind of shock your body or the ground can transfer, and ability to compensate for any kind of weight changes such as the focal length throughout the video shoot. And as promised, here's the bonus test I did. So remember that last test, I put the RS2 on this super smooth mode but didn't do anything to Crane 2S. So you might be thinking, oh, that's not really fair for Crane 2S. So just for the heck of it, I put Crane 2S on the high motor power, and here's the result. Crane 2S is 44% smoother than the RS2 at that test. So there you have it, guys. Crane 2S is the king of single-handle gimbal in the land of straight-line smoothness. So I hope I was able to provide information you can't find anywhere on the internet. So technically, you have hit the end of the internet. Please go back. Alright guys, so here comes all the comparison footage side by side. Please enjoy. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Until next time, later.
My pants coming down. Okay, I gotta pick up my pants.